Hello and welcome to IndianExpress.com. In a massive blow to AIADMK General Secretary Sasikala Natarajan, the Supreme Court has convicted her in the DA case and has set aside the High Court order of the initial High Court order, which had earlier acquitted former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, late Jayalalitha, as well as three others. What this essentially means is that Sasikala Natarajan will no longer be holding or be contesting for the Chief Minister's post. Let's go across to my colleague Nandagopal Rajan to throw more light on what this big Supreme Court verdict means for the politically charged state of Tamil Nadu. Nandagopal, first of all, the big question, what does this ruling mean for the political career of Sasikala Natarajan?
So the ruling means that she will be in jail for 4 years, okay, followed by a suspension from contesting election for 6 years. So for 10 years, she cannot hold a post,
okay,
at least an elected post. So she cannot be chief minister or a minister or an MP or an MLA for 10 years at least. So she's out of the picture for 10 years. She can. So this means that at least for now, this entire contest between Pannerselvam and Sasikala is over, because it's only Pannerselvam left in the frame now. And Sasikala is out of the picture. Sasikala can still hold the cards, and she might voice somebody who she likes as the chief minister. Or the chief ministerial candidate, and there might still be a floor test in which, or the AIADMK might say that okay, we are all going back to Pannerselvam, and he is going to continue as a chief minister. But for now, Sasikala is out of the picture. She cannot be chief minister, and she cannot be chief minister for 10 years.
Right. So now, what does this judgment effectively mean for the entire faction of Pannerselvam? Now that we know that probably half of the MLAs who were still probably allegedly holed up in the resort, what does it now mean for Pannerselvam? Will those MLAs be probably backing Pannerselvam? Will he be the only true person left to take on the legacy of Jayalalitha?
It's an interesting question, because AIADMK has traditionally not had a second rung. The only person, like, everybody knew as the person who is the backup to Jayalalitha has always been Pannerselvam, and it's been like that for well over a decade. So it could be a natural process for all the MLAs to say that now, since Sasikala is also out of the picture, that we are all going to back Pannerselvam, who always had the had the stamp of Jayalalitha.
Okay.
No, Jayalalitha always wanted him as her second person, as a backup person. So it's possible that the AIADMK flock sort of moves towards Pannerselvam and says that okay, you continue to be our chief minister, or the entire Sasikala clan sort of starts playing their cards and ensures that somebody from within this group of 130 MLAs, or somebody from the family, for instance, takes over the party and becomes the chief minister.
Right.
So it is very fluid now. All possibilities are open except for the possibility of Sasikala becoming chief minister.
So clearly the crisis within the AIADMK still continues. It's just that the names probably have changed.
Yeah,
we just still have Pannerselvam on one side, mm-hmm, but probably Sasikala could come up with some other person to take on Pannerselvam.
I'm pretty certain they will foist a new name, to take on Pannerselvam. But it's going to get more and more interesting now.
Clearly, the drama, of course, continuing in that state of Tamil Nadu. Thank you so much, Nandagopal, for giving us details on that big Supreme Court ruling, which has created a massive setback for Sasikala Natarajan, who has been convicted in the disproportionate assets case. For more news and updates, log on to IndianExpress.com.